guys, it's your boy FaZe Rug, and I'm here with my beautiful brother,
Broadus.
And today, we're gonna be eating the world's
You can never go wrong with Broadus, bro. Broadus is a man.
Like, I'm waiting for the day you call me and you're like, yo, bro, do you want to help me with a video? And it's not a video that's, like, damaging to my health.
What about the Christmas video that we just did?
That was so damaging to my health because I was so happy with the gift you got me, I started crying.
You were shaking, so it did affect me.
Exactly.
Guys, this is kind of like a mukbang, but we're actually going to be answering the spiciest questions about us.
I'm not good with spicy foods at all.
Well, I'm just gonna dig in. How about that?
Okay, well, he is my brother, so I'm gonna match his energy and also dig in.
All right, so we're gonna start with something that I don't think anybody knows, and I don't think we've ever talked about it. Maybe my mom has talked about it, but did you guys know we should have had a sister?
Bianca.
Unfortunately and sadly, my mom had a miscarriage. I was 7, I think.
I was 8.
She would have been 19 now. That's crazy.
Our little sister would have been in college right now. How crazy.
Making YouTube videos. I don't think I've ever talked about that, so.
People still learn something new about you 10 years after you make videos. There's always like new things to learn every day.
Okay, let's get a little ASMR moment. Hold on, ready?
Here's my ASMR.
I don't know if that's satisfying or annoying. Let's get into some celebrity crushes.
You want me to start?
I want you to start.
Oh, my girl from Spain, Rosalia.
Rosalia.
I love her, bro. Like,
obviously, everyone knows my celebrity crush for the longest time was Kylie Jenner. And honestly, she still is. Like,
yeah, but you grow out of relationships, you know?
Yeah. Well, guys, my celebrity crush is Jenna Ortega, star of Wednesday.
Wait, I thought you were going to say Devin Booker.
He's right there. On to the next question. Who's the most famous celebrity you've ever met, and what was the experience like? I think we all know your answer, so just go ahead.
Devin Booker. I would say I'm pretty close to D-Book. I met him a bunch of times. I've been to his house. He's been to my house.
That's crazy, bro. Let me talk about who I've met that's the most famous person, which I think everyone knows. Kylie Jenner. I can't believe I could still say that I met Kylie Jenner. Why are you looking at me all shocked?
I thought you were gonna say Bawadis.
Okay, I'm gonna try to talk about this without, like, I met Kylie Jenner at the Ace Family's gender reveal at Kylie's house. Yo, wait, it's hard to think. I don't know how I could do it.
This is the last question of the video, right?
Listen, I was very nervous because back in the day, all the OGs know I used to talk about Kylie Jenner in almost all of my Call of Duty videos.
And off camera, too.
I remember I spotted her, and I obviously didn't want to go up to ask for a picture, but...
Spotted her. She's like a Pokemon.
Listen, I couldn't even ask for a picture because they made you lock your phones in a bag.
That's crazy.
Yeah, we'll pop one up on the screen. Like, they do that at a lot of like celebrity events. I saw her after like a few hours. We actually made eye contact, and you won't believe it. She actually came up to me and she was like, oh my gosh, hi. And I was like, dude, what the hell? This is Kylie Jenner. I didn't try to fanboy or anything. But I hugged her. I said, hi. You killed it with all the decorations and everything. And she was like, oh, thank you so much. After that, it was just very quick. It was like a 10-second interaction. And I just said, like, thank you for having me. And then she walked away. And to this day, I still regret not asking for a picture because I'm sure she would have said yes because she knew who I was. But I didn't want to, like, go through the trouble of unlocking the Ziploc. And I probably would have been shaking. And, like, the phone would have probably dropped. I need you to attend. I need you to be more attentive.
Bro, do you know how hot these things are? Okay, can I ask you, why didn't you get like a regular like cereal bowl? What is up with this incredible whole plate?
I saw Matt Stoney do it.
Dude, that's Matt Stoney.
Let's move on, Brandon.
Okay, next question. Come on, bro.
Who are the top 3 YouTubers you watch right now? And if there's one that you specifically look up to and motivates you and inspires you, who is it?
Okay, so 2 people that I watch, I mean, they post YouTube videos, but they're not known as YouTubers. Speed and Aiden Ross. They're just funny as hell. Like, and I love how real they are, how raw they are. The last person that I watch consistently every time he posts, Notification Squad, FaZe Rug.
Bro.
I watch all of Brian's videos. And to answer your last question, if there's anyone I look up to as motivation, it is my brother. Because, I mean, I've said this in my videos, but I'll say it in my brother's. So I just recently hit 6 million YouTube subscribers. If it wasn't for Brian, I just watch and learn how hard he works, the steps that he takes to be great, like how much he puts into every single video, no days off, no shortcuts, doesn't have anything. I take that and then I apply it to my work ethic. So that's what I mean. I wouldn't have 6 million subs without you because I wouldn't have anyone to look up to, which is weird to say because you're my younger brother.
Thank you.
But this is just true.
So my top 3 YouTubers as of right now, I would say Mr. Beast is up there and he's always been up there. That was epic. Juan, you are so freaking funny, and I do want to make a collab video with you. They're genuinely just hilarious. Top YouTuber right now, I don't think a lot of people know this, but it's Loaf. Bro, Loaf is so funny, bro. Like, I actually watch a lot of mic'd up YouTubers, as they're called, the mic'd up cult. I actually came up with that name, for those who don't know. When Jadeon was at my house, I called you guys the mic'd up cult. And he's like, yo, that's actually unique. So now a lot of people say the mic'd up cult. I'm taking credit for that one.
Bro, this is no joke. I know some people eat this for fun. I don't know what's wrong with you guys.
Next question, have you ever denied a picture?
I never have, and I can answer that for you. You never have either.
There's no way, dude.
Some people do come off a little bit rude. There's a proper way to ask somebody for a picture. It's like, I'll do the proper way.
Okay.
Yo, what's up, bro? I love your videos, man. You think I can get a picture?
Of course, bro. I appreciate
thank
you, for
thank
real.
You, bro. I don't want to bother you, but let's get it. Let's
bro,
get
it's
that.
Not a bother at all.
Okay. Now, there's some people that will be like, hey, yo, Rug, let's take a picture.
I don't mind that, but there are some people that will come up and they'll be very, like, touchy. Like, hey, yo, Rug, yo, turn around.
And they'll just take their phone out. They won't even ask. No matter how disrespectful or rude they come off, we still have never denied a picture. You'd have to do something crazy that has never been done before for us to be like, no picture.
I'm not going
to
lie. I did get denied a picture from an NBA player.
Russell what?
Yeah.
Oh, wait, should I not say the name?
No, yeah, you can say it.
Russell Westbrook.
Guys, I'm not gonna lie, like, all respect to Westbrook. I freaking love him, but I was at a YG listening party, and I saw a lot of celebrities there. Like, we were in, like, a little private room, and I saw Westbrook, bro. He's massive in person. Like, he's so tall.
6'4", super built.
And I go up, I'm like, yo, Westbrook, can I get a picture? They're like, nah. And I'm like, all right, sorry.
But why, like...
Dude, I don't know if we're going to eat a lot more, but let's just get into some...
Like, I'm down to keep answering the questions. Okay, bro, I have a question now. Before I ask this question, listen to this ASMR. It's not an eating one. It's just listen. Dude. Okay. My question is, there's obviously a lot of positives to being a YouTuber. A lot. What would you say is the downside of being a social media influencer or a YouTuber as big as you are?
Sometimes I think the downside is reading the bad comments. Even though it doesn't affect me as much, it's just your every move gets watched and judged, which sucks.
I think when you're in a relationship, when you're dating somebody, a lot of times relationships work better private. Unfortunately, with, you know, my job and my brother's job, if you're dating a girl, it's gonna be open to the public. So me, I personally believe that, obviously everyone knows me and Jackie were dating. I personally believe a lot of our problems and a big reason why we broke up was because everything... was so public. Every single job has pros and cons, and luckily the job we have has way more pros than cons, but that is one downside, I'd say. Okay, Brian, so I want to ask you a question that obviously I already know the answer to, but I feel like a lot of people watching this video want to hear you say it. Are your ghost videos fake?
I literally ran into a supporter today that literally asked me that. That is a frequently asked question, and I'm gonna keep it 100% real with you guys. They are not fake.
I mean, you've shown proof, like video proof.
And like, you weren't like a strong believer in it either until it's happened to you and all the experiences that we've had. And then that video we did at our old house was absolutely terrifying. The animatronics going off on their own. So honestly, there's people that genuinely just don't believe in ghosts. So like, I respect that they just think they're fake, and that's totally fine. But like, there are actual people that have experienced real ghost paranormal encounters in person, and they're firm believers of it.
Yeah, me too, bro.
People that actually relate to what we film. So I truly don't mind if people think they're fake. What's the most money that you spent on a
Gotcha.
Your answer is a video that you just filmed recently. If I had to guess, it had to have been that video if you want to tell them.
Well, we just did our annual Christmas gifts opening video, which by the way, you guys absolutely love and I love as well. I did spend over $70,000 just on gifts. And I know a lot of people are thinking like, damn, Rug probably just regrets it, or Rug probably like thinks that he shouldn't have spent that much. But to be honest, like, I didn't have a second thought about it. I knew exactly what I wanted to get everyone, and I'm like, honestly, it's gonna make them happy. It's once a year, it's Christmas, and that's definitely the most I've spent on a video.
Bro, you know what's crazy? So you spent over $70,000 on 20 people, right? How about I tell you, I spent $20,000 only on you, my mom, my dad, Dennis, and Nora. $20,000 on 5 people. So that's definitely the highest budget video I've ever made, but I would have got you guys those gifts anyways. The difference is it was just on camera, but I don't regret it at all. It's family. I love you guys.
You really got me a Cartier bracelet.
I got your Cartier bracelet, which
that was sick.
That contributed pretty heavily to the $20,000 debt.
I think so too.
All right, bro. I think we have time for one more question because I'm not gonna lie. Even though we're not really eating the noodles, the stench is just coming up to our face. How about one more question? Is that fine?
That's fine.
What is it like being swatted? Obviously, swatting is a big topic now that's been happening to streamers.
I'm not gonna lie, I just got swatted last month. It's terrifying, it's horrible, it's illegal. Anyone who does it should actually face prison time because they're putting your life at risk. It was about 1:30 a.m. and I woke up, I had like 3 missed calls from a private number, and I'm just like, that's kind of weird. Like, it woke me up, and then I heard a loud bang downstairs, like boom, 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 boom. And I'm like, bro, it's either someone trying to break into my house or it's the cops. So I look out my window, 6 cop cars, 6 of them were holding their weapons. They're like in position pointing at my door, and I look out the window and I'm scared. Like, obviously I know I didn't do anything wrong, but any wrong move can put your life at risk. So I went downstairs, luckily I opened the door, and I'm just like, guys, it's a prank call, I'm a YouTuber. Like, I just like explained all that stuff, and they realized who I was because they had swatted our previous house like 6 times. Definitely scary, like when you walk out there's literal cops with weapons pointed right at you.
It's a traumatizing experience to have a weapon pointed at your face. Like, that's something you don't forget for the rest of your life.
I couldn't sleep after that. I just hope that anyone who's even thinking about it or has done it, like, I hope you realize that you're genuinely putting people's lives at risk, and you will end up getting caught, and you will end up spending time in prison. Like, it's not a joke.
Look, I won't even answer the question of like what it's like getting swatted, because I feel like you and I share the same feelings towards it, but I will answer how many times we've been swatted. The first house we lived in, 5 or 6 times. The second house, the one you just moved out of, 6, 7 times. That's already 12, 13 times. And then you just got swatted here. I'd say around 15 times we've been swatted. Ask Aiden Ross how it feels being swatted. It's happened to him 2 or 3 times.
He's definitely expressed it. Like, it's just not a good thing. Like, you feel like your life can just end. It's like a 50-50 chance.
And they say like the craziest things that like you understand why they have their weapons pointed at you.
Can I tell you what the reason was for this one?
Yeah, cool.
They thought that I had a rocket launcher in my house.
What is
that? Oh, fuck.
That's literally what I said. I told the cop this. I said, the only rocket launcher I have is in Call of Duty. He started telling me, he's like, you play Warzone? I'm like, yeah, I play Warzone. He's like, what do you think about the new COD? And I'm like, dude, can you put your down a little bit? Like, I'll talk to you about it. I'm kind of scared.
For me, I walked out, hands up. They're like, where are your mom and dad? I'm like, they're inside. Where are your mom and dad? I'm like, my mom's making breakfast and my dad is watching Netflix. The call had said that I did something to my parents and that I was trying to escape the house, like leave the house. And I'm like, dude, oh my God. Like, it just sounds so crazy, but.
No, it's awful, guys. Well, this was fun. Not the food aspect
of it. Hold on. This was fun, not this.
I kind of just want to get a comparison of what our plates look now versus the beginning, because I feel like they barely moved.
Okay, it looks like they barely moved, but these are big, deep plates. So we did take a good chunk, but obviously not no Matt Stoney, Joey Chestnut.
Hey, I love being more raw with our conversations and just telling stories, and I know you guys like that kind of stuff, so please drop a like if you want to see more stuff like this. You know, different guests, the whole family.
What's up? What's up with the different guests? What did I
love? Oh, yeah, no, you're never coming back.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Facts.
But make sure you guys hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you all with the next video.